everybody. Welcome to another. Really need to get a new camera. Looks so unflattering.
We'll get a nice one for the next. Let's put that on the shopping list for.
Put it on the list.
Yeah.
Anyways, welcome everybody to Lindsay practice stream.
You seem so enthused.
Welcome. I'm not playing with this for my sake. This is not an anxiety tool.
Luna is just.
I have a dog down here that is like, give me the carrot. Give me the freaking carrot. This is called animal cruelty right here.
Give me the carrot.
Go get it. She's like, let me after it. Anyways, hi everybody. Guys, guess what? I decided as of last night or as of yesterday, I'm gonna be more present on social media again. I have
Woo!
To like,
woo!
Yeah. Posted a TikTok yesterday, posted one today. I just told Fish, I was like, all right, I'm gonna start posting every day again. Which is funny because hi from Oklahoma, how are you, the music artist? But it's funny because I have to like go in spurts and I have to compartmentalize. It's exhausting,
yeah.
And you have to take breaks. But also it's like when I, you know, talk to my managers and find out that like I have to be really focused on one project, it's really hard to like divide myself in half and be like, okay, we're gonna work really hard on this, but we're also gonna work really hard on this, and then I end up just doing, you know, kind of crappy at both. So anyways, I've been focusing very much on the album. I'm like almost pretty much done with it. So
I have a lot of jokes I want to make about that, about how like I can barely get groceries for you and like go shopping for myself in the same day. So I don't know how you do it. You do it well.
No, that's okay. You're not giving yourself enough credit.
I do it like 10%.
You are so good at grocery shopping.
Thank you.
No, that's not what I was gonna say.
It's funny though. I'll pick up like sweet potatoes and I'll be like, she would be disappointed in this one, and I'll put it back. Like, I get angry at the grocery store when things aren't like the right size.
Yeah,
you know.
This cilantro is wilted!
Yeah, none of these are up to my standard for her.
My artist will not accept this!
Oh,
no, but you do, like, she's selling herself short. Fish does so much on tour to keep our entire tour running. And, oh my gosh, thank you for gifting so many subs. Malakia Fletcher.
Oh,
thank you. Okay, I'm going to play some music now.
Has it been a while, or are you... I guess you've been playing a lot
of
Christmas
music. I've been recording.
Yeah,
I've got a lot of Christmas music in my brain.
Yeah.
Like, literally all I can think of is, like, jingle bells ringing in my head. And no, I did not cover jingle bells. Well, actually...
You tried.
I tried.
Yeah.
I tried really hard.
It's hard, yeah.
It's hard to make jingle bells new and cool. It's just got to be jingle bells, jingle
bells. It's really not a cool song, though.
Yeah, there's a couple Christmas songs. I won't be naming them because they'll get offended. But there's
the
quite a few those writers will be after me. There's so many Christmas songs that you're like, this just isn't the best song. It's a classic and people love it, but like, I don't want to play this for the next few years on Christmas tours. It's so fun thinking about this next Christmas tour though, and like.
Oh.
Suddenly
so
we get to revamp it. We have new music to
I'm
play
so
with.
I'm so excited.
I don't get offended. I'm Irish. Do Irish not get offended? Because I'm Scottish.
Probably a lot less than, like,
yeah,
us.
Maybe they're more blunt. I'm Scottish and I sure get offended.
Me too. Yeah. Okay.
Not one of my gifts. Like, I wish I'm trying to learn that truth concept to not take things personally. You know,
it's hard.
It's really hard.
Yeah.
All right. Someone requested Artemis. Carol of the Bells 2.0. Now that would be something. asking if this is my crystallized violin. No, it's not. This is Excalibur. But I have my crystallized violin up in my studio. By the way, I think there are still some available for sale. The crystallized violin. I think that it's mostly sold out, but there might be a few left. So if people are interested in getting that, that's exciting. How many songs on the Christmas album? There's only 13.
Wow.
13.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. That's wow. A lot.
That's a lot. That's a lot of songs.
For how fast it was put together.
I was going to say.
My goal was, yeah. I was like, let's get 10. Let's get 10. But then.
Let's hope for 10.
Yeah. I was like, if I get 10, I'll be happy. But then it kind of came down to it, and I liked, like, and then we decided, okay, 12 is a perfect number. I think that's, like, the perfect number for an album, personally. But then, one of the bonus songs kept getting better and better and better, and so I just was like, well, I need to make a new bonus track, because this is too good to be a bonus. It's that one random one, I don't even think you've heard it since. It's that one that was, like, kind of rock-ish.
Oh, yeah, okay.
And it turned out really good, and so I was like, I hit up my managers and was like, guys, am I crazy that this is too good to be a bonus track? And they're like, actually, we agree.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Great.
Also, I saw someone asking on here a couple things. How many violins do I own? I need to go and actually count. I think I
want to say, come on, I did an inventory.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Now, this also includes, like, violins that are kind of just decorative.
Yes, that counts.
You couldn't play it. I think that it's counts. 19.
Wow, 19.
I think it's 19, yeah.
Also, I have some that I need to get rid of. Like, there's a couple acoustic violins.
Yeah.
I don't know where they came from.
Yeah.
I'm like, where? Like, I think they were given to me at
you
some point.
A random violin.
And then there's like a 2/3 size. There's a half size in there. I'm like, where did these come from, and how did I acquire them?
Let's decorate them and get rid of them.
Yeah.
Let's put our own little personal touches.
Yes. Yeah. So, guys, violins coming soon. How many songs on the Christmas album? I answered that. Someone was asking if I was coming to Mexico in 2022. I don't think I'm coming this year. And that's not for trying. I've actually asked my agents multiple times to include Mexico in a tour. Like, I was like, I really want to go back to Mexico, and it's just not going to happen this year. I even asked them if they could please put it in my Christmas tour routing, mm-hmm. and they said that wasn't going to happen either. So it's not for lack of trying, but we are definitely coming there in 2023 when we'll be touring.
Touring Christmas is hard because you have a very tiny window to
yes.
get it in.
And they made it very clear that we would lose, like, because, like, it's such a small window, mm-hmm. and we would lose so many days traveling not only from city to city, but to get to Mexico and to get through customs with all the trucks and everything. They were like,
it takes a long time.
They're like, it's not going to be worth it. You'll lose too much. So, sorry about that. I really did try. I even asked, I was like, what if we did, like, an early...
Right.
You know, show there. Like,
early November.
Yeah, like early November. Go to Mexico and do like a, hey, this is our Christmas tour. Sorry we're early. They said no.
We'll get there.
Don't you worry. Any Halloween theme songs on the Christmas album? There's actually, like, I would say there's two songs that to me sound like they could be kind of Halloween-esque.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember even thinking that, and it was intentional as I was writing it. I was like, this is a perfect song to bleed from Halloween into Christmas. So that's a funny question that someone asked. I love that, because that was a thought. I've got two. Yo, Lindsay, no long time no see. A strumming, nice to see you as well. Also, guys, coming up in, like, less than an hour, so in a half hour, I'm going to be doing one of my AMP radio shows today with Jax. She is freaking awesome.
I love her.
She is so brilliant, so fun, and I'm really excited for our conversation today. It's just going to be hanging out and chatting all things, you know, being an artist, TikTok, marketing yourself. Yeah, I see so many people saying, Jax! Yeah, she's awesome. She's also, like, become a friend of mine, so I'm very stoked to talk to her. Okay. Ooh, someone requested Spontaneous Me. Okay. I'm going to try to see if I remember it. Thank you. first original song that I ever, like, released.
Wow.
Spontaneous Me.
Nice.
First, like, electronic song that I ever did, where I was like, I'm gonna try this. Which is kind of a funny thought. And it's funny, listening to that beginning melody, it works in the song, but I'm like, I would never write that now. Like, like wrote, you know, so it's like, okay, Electric Daisy. Oh, never mind, that was Electric Daisy. People are like, that's Electric Daisy. Oh my gosh.
I mean, you have countless songs that I, as your employee who have worked for you for 4 years, still have never heard. So, you know, that's fine.
Now I'm like, how does Spontaneous go?
Do I need to pull it up on
YouTube? No, I'm going to remember it. Okay, I remember the chorus. Sorry, that was Electric Daisy. That was like the fifth song I ever wrote. Or fourth. It was the fourth one. If I could just remember the key. Song I ever wrote, and nice. you can tell. But that's actually, if you listen to the track, it's actually quite a fun song, very Celtic inspired, you know. About my first album is that I didn't really understand writing that well. Like, I didn't know, no one ever taught me how to write a song, and I'd only ever really studied classical music, where
the
classical music kind of goes where it wants to go, and so these songs very much so they go where they want to go. I wasn't kind of confined by this idea that, like, oh no, like, the melody has to repeat itself. Like, you have to come back to that original melody. Like, you have to make a motif. It was like, well, but I want to go over there. And there's, like, a certain amount of freedom in that first album that I kind of really love. And, you know, and I'm grateful that I wrote an entire album not knowing better. And also not having anyone to tell me that that's not how it's done. You know, like, no one was sitting next to me being like, Lindsay, you gotta, you know, you gotta do it right.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. I saw someone request Masquerade. Yeah, if you see, here's Luna right here. See people pointing her out? I will say, one of the new songs on the Christmas album has a bit of a Masquerade feel, wouldn't you say?
Yes, in a very fun way.
I'm very excited
about it. It's probably one of my favorites.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorites, so you have that to look forward to, because, I mean, Masquerade is one of my favorites. I will say on stream, whenever I see someone request Masquerade, I'm like, okay, let's do Masquerade. I just really enjoy playing that song, so it makes me feel very posh. How's trapeze going, Lindsay? I just posted a funny TikTok today.
I laughed so hard. I can't remember. I remember the word. Who talks the word cookies? And we were laughing so hard at it.
Thank you. I was like, I wonder if anyone else is going to be like, wait, her cookies? What is she talking about? So, cookies is
was
what?
Was
it no, it was.
It was Liza.
Liza Rose. It was when one of us, I don't remember who, so I posted a video, I should explain, on TikTok and Instagram Reels today, and it's me repeatedly falling on the trapeze bar on my crotch.
It happens.
There's certain tricks where you're, like, winding through this thing, and you're, like, relying on your body, and then all of a sudden, you think you're landing on your thigh, but you are coming down right on your cookies on the bar. And, yeah, our coach, Liza Rose, we were getting ready for the Christmas tour. I think, I don't remember which one of us, like, did that. And I was like, oh! And she goes, oh, did you get your cookies?
Yeah, that's right.
And
we died.
So funny. So, I got my cookies. and I just posted a video. And it was to that Kylie Jenner audio where she's like, I'm an athlete. Like, you know, every blood test I've ever taken has shown that I have above-level skill as an athlete. And
it really doesn't make me want to take up aerial art. That's for sure.
Yeah. So good. It's so fun. I have a lesson tomorrow, actually.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, you should.
I'm going to sleep all day tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, you need to sleep.
I'm probably not going to wake up
tomorrow. Another day, though, you should come in and try some aerial. I think you would actually.
I'm going to love it.
Love it.
Yeah.
It's very empowering. It's very like.
I need some empowerment in my life. That's for sure. I need some some womanly empowerment in my life right now.
I know, you're pretty empowered. I wouldn't say that's like a need you have. I mean, I think everyone can use that in their life, but like, I wouldn't say you're lacking.
Well, thank you, Lindsay.
You know, you got some feminine spirit over here.
Yeah.
Oh, dang. Okay. Flying fish, they say? Yeah.
I'll make that my new thing, the flying fish, as I fly off of the trapeze bar onto the mat.
New album, someone's asking. Well, I just finished, or am finishing, a Christmas album, and I'm literally immediately going to start going into writing for, like, trying. I took a break from it and hoping that a break might have solved the problem.
Do you think your chat can hear this?
Can you guys hear that?
They can definitely hear that.
It's not me.
Oh my god, look at this.
Luna, get it! I just had to distract her. But yeah, I'm going to work back on the rock album again and hope that I can make sense of it. But having that one, like, rock-inspired Christmas song made me be like, I can do this.
Yeah.
I can do this.
I mean, I am pouring... When we manifest, I'm manifesting the rock album. Even though I know that, you know, you might not go that direction. You might. I don't know.
I'm going to try for it, guys.
That's where I'm putting my manifestation.
I like it. Okay. Yeah. Well,
selfishly.
On that note... someone says, oh my gosh, Lindsay, the very same from YouTube. I guess so. I mean, I'm assuming there's more than one Lindsay on YouTube, but if you're looking
for on
the one that's... Yes, you are.
I don't have a YouTube.
But you're on my YouTube, probably.
Yeah, I guess. Anyways,
I'm one of the Lindsays from YouTube. It's so funny, because, I mean, I totally get it, how... You know, it's like we're interested in something for a while, and then you know, your interests change, and you just start following other people, and you unfollow someone, because, you know, it's no longer what you're excited about. We all do it. And so it's always funny to me, though, like, I've existed this whole time. I'm very aware that I've been working hard and my butt off for the last 10, 12 years, you know? And so it's always funny when people are like, whoa, Lindsay Sterling, haven't heard of her in years. And I'm like, I've been here all the time. I've been working my ass off. Sorry, bad language.
Spread the word.
Yeah, but I've been here. I never went anywhere. It's not like this is a comeback. I am newer to Twitch. I've been doing Twitch for like 2 years. But anyways.
The pandemic doesn't count, though. Like, nobody actually existed those years.
Yeah,
you know?
That didn't count. So yeah. I guess, and anything that started in the pandemic feels so recent.
Oh my gosh. It's so, like, I mean, sometimes I think
you
back,
and I just
like,
became friends.
I know. Oh my gosh, right? I think back on March 2020, and it's like that feels like it was few months ago.
I know.
No, it wasn't.
It's not.
No.
It's not. Guess what? We aged during that time too, believe it or not. Ugh. I know. That's wild too.
Oh gosh, we're in the middle of our 30s now.
Don't remind me. Somebody
told me, they thought somebody on the plane that I was on today.
Oh no.
They were like, you gotta be what, 26?
Okay.
And I screamed inside. It was a good way. I was like, oh yes, I'm 26. You nailed it.
Absolutely. Oh my gosh, take that back, purple mushroom. Oh my gosh, it's Lindsay from AGT.
Oh no.
Lindsay has done a lot more since AGT. It was much more noteworthy.
Much more impressive things.
Much more impressive, like just a better experience, better viewing experience. Yeah. Anyways, I'm just kidding. Thank you for remembering me. Now everybody is saying it. Oh my gosh, it's Lindsay. You know, you guys are all pulling my name, my leg, and my name. All right, I'm going to... It's Lindsay from Dancing with the Stars.
I probably got another, like, 4 minutes.
Okay, I'm going to play one last little song. I saw someone request... I'm loving this. I saw someone request Sleepwalking.
Yeah.
Thank you. comments are absolutely so killing me right now.
I want to say,
pick your favorite.
Chat, but our mod Hannah said, "Oh, we're not talking about Chips Ahoy, are we? We're talking about cookies." No, Hannah.
Maybe, but I mean, it was something else. But if you want to consider it Chips Ahoy, that's fine. You think of it that way.
Yeah.
Some of these comments, I want to say some of my favorites here. It's that girl that looks like Felba. That's a really good one from Holly Bradley. The girl that was on the cover of that one book. I like that one.
Lacey said, I thought I was watching Reba McEntire's stream.
Oh, I love it. Someone says, oh, she was in that, she did a music video with Sophie Dossie, which is hilarious. Sophie Dossie was in my music video for Underground. She's the hoop girl. Yeah. She's amazing. She is incredible.
There you go.
Anyways, loving these. Also, last comment. Oh my gosh, it's Lindsay from AMP.
There we go.
So guys, speaking of, I'm going to jump off here soon. Please join me on AMP in 10 minutes. We'll be going live with Jax. It's going to be such a great conversation. Yeah. It's just chill, fun, friends chatting it up. And so join us on AMP. Please download the AMP app. Use code Lindsay Sterling. The chat has the link for you right there.
And if you can't, come join us in Discord.
Yes, if you can't, because I know that it's only available on iPhones and for
US.
But
they say they're working on it.
Yeah, they are. They keep saying we're working on it, and I keep pressuring them. Like, please do this ASAP. I got peeps. So, yeah, you can go onto the Discord, and you can listen on there. Also, even if you are listening on AMP, if you're on Discord, it allows us to see your comments. So if you have questions you want to ask Jax, then put them in there. Anyways, on that note, I'm going to sign off here, but I hope to see you in 10 minutes, and we'll be back next week. Hopefully next week. Next week, we'll give you the full hour. I apologize that we were running a little late today.
Yeah.
So, anyways.
We'll see you guys then.